scheduled takedown request. And that's for cases, yeah, exactly.
Okay, ooh.
Copyright strike. And so you may want to give that
a- You just said a very scary word there. Hello, insiders. Welcome to another video. Today, we are going to talk about a feature that is just newly being released to all partners in YPP. So hello, my name is Barbara.
Hey, I'm Cameron. I'm a product specialist on the content ID team.
Okay, so we got some content ID stuff for you. Tell us why you're here.
So as you mentioned, we're really excited to announce that we just finished rolling out the copyright match tool to all creators in the YouTube Partner Program.
We were having a little chat before we started filming this. I have no clue what a copyright match tool is, so please tell our Insider Nation what this actually is.
So the tool is designed to find re-uploads of your content on other channels. So it's in the new YouTube Studio.
Okay.
When you first access the tool, you're going to have to activate it to start off. But then after that, whenever you upload a video to YouTube, we're going to scan other videos uploaded to YouTube to try to see if any of them are the same or very, very similar. Once we do find one of those matches, we populate that in the Matches tab of the tool. And then from there, it's kind of up to you to decide what happens next. So you can either leave the video up, you can send a message to the other uploader, or you can ask us to take the video down.
Yo, why are you uploading my video, man?
Well, the thing that we had in mind was more if you maybe want to suggest a collaboration in the future.
Okay.
Or something like that. Yeah, right. There may be some opportunities to join forces, so this doesn't have to be kind of a contentious experience. We've just gotten a lot of feedback over the years about how frustrating it can be when your upload is actually re-uploaded to a different channel without your permission.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, story time with Barbara. I do have, you guys know if you watch these videos, I have a personal gaming channel, and some of my videos were taken from my channel, and they were uploaded on somebody else's channel. They were sped up, and then those got more views. And I was super bummed about that, because I kind of liked those videos. So are you saying I could have, if this tool had existed a couple years ago, I could have used this tool to do something with this other channel?
Exactly. That's exactly what this tool is for. Basically, we just know it's so hard to find these re-uploads in the first place. It can be super time-consuming.
Yeah.
And then once you do, what happens then? It can be difficult to know what your next steps are.
Mm-hmm. So in this particular example, what is stopping this other channel from matching me and either sending me a message or taking down my video?
Look at who uploaded the video first. So that's our way.
That was me.
That's a way of knowing who created the video.
Okay.
So if you are creating a video off of YouTube, it's just really important to get the video onto YouTube as quickly as possible because we want you to be the first person who uploaded it.
Yep.
That way we can know that it's your original creation.
Where do I find this? You said it's in Studio Beta. Mm-hmm. Where is it?
So if you go to the channel section, it's going to be one of the options on the left-hand navigation. It'll say copyright. It'll be the title of the tab.
How do you actually find matches?
We actually use the same matching technology as the Content ID tool.
Okay.
But we've put in a lot of work to make it both easier to use and to work specifically for YouTube creators.
Surprise! Change in location. We got kicked out of the other meeting room. In the meantime, as we were moving over, so I actually loaded up Creator Insider and I pulled up the copyright match tool, and it turns out we have a bunch of matches. What do I do with this list now?
That's a really good question. This tool is designed basically to find potential re-uploads, but we have no way of knowing the context of that match.
Yeah.
So it's really, really important to review each and every one really carefully. And there are probably a few things that would be helpful to keep in mind. Things like, is it really your original content that matched? Or maybe did your video contain some stuff that you didn't necessarily own or produce yourself?
Yep. Okay.
Or is the use that we found of that content, is it in a manner that might be protected by fair use or some other relevant circumstance? Maybe you gave permission to another creator to use some clips from your video.
Mm-hmm.
So these are all things to keep in mind that may change your decision on what action you want to take against one of these videos.
Yeah.
Once you do decide that, you know, this video is within your rights to decide what happens to this video, you're going to have a couple options. So if you're cool with that reuse, or you think maybe your channel can get some additional exposure from it, something like that, then you can just go ahead and leave it up. You don't have to do anything at all. You can dismiss it or send it to the archive, is what it's called in the tool.
Okay.
If you, like I mentioned earlier, if you think you might have an opportunity to collaborate with this channel or something like that, you can send that creator a message in the tool and kick off a conversation that way.
Okay.
Or if you really don't want that, if you're not comfortable with that video being on YouTube, then you can send us a request to take it down.
Say I click this button here that says request video removal. Will this video be removed from YouTube right now? We missed one step. You also need to fill out a copyright takedown request web form, a little form on the internet where you give more information. And I have a couple pro tips for you. Please make sure that you fill out this form accurately and completely. Not doing so will result in delays with our processing your request. And I have a little pro tip. When you are filling out your name as the claimant, please make sure that you are using your full and complete legal name, not your channel name.
We check for things like completeness and accuracy of the request. So sometimes a video won't be removed right away.
Okay.
Keep an eye open for an email that confirms that we've been able to process the request, or maybe we might have to ask you for more information before we can take action.
Okay. Do you make the video unlisted or private, or do anything about it?
So nothing happens.
Nothing happens to the video
until we feel comfortable processing that takedown. Nothing will happen to the video.
Okay.
So make sure you keep a close eye on your email, because if it really is something that you think infringes on your rights, then we want to make sure that we take care of it as quickly as possible.
When I hit request video removal, does that channel get notified in any way?
So they won't get notified until it's approved. Okay. And so okay. It's taking okay. The next steps towards being processed. But actually, I'm glad you brought that up, because we have a really, really cool feature that we added into this tool called a scheduled takedown request. And that's for cases... Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
I'm glad
why,
I get to
why
explain.
Do I want to schedule these things?
Well, it's for cases where a standard takedown request might feel a little bit too harsh.
Okay.
Because a takedown request comes, in most cases, along with a copyright strike. And so you may want to give that other channel a chance to address it first if you don't want to give them that copyright strike.
You just said a very scary word there. You just said strike. Strike is issued?
And the channel that re-uploaded your content would receive a copyright strike.
To clarify for all of you, it's very important for you to know, getting one copyright strike on your channel does not remove functionality of any features whatsoever.
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
But back to that scheduled takedown request.
Okay.
I just want to talk through it all the way to the end. So basically what happens, you send this scheduled takedown request. We send a notification to that channel that re-uploaded the content,
Yep. Letting
them know they have 7 days to take the video down themselves and avoid getting a copyright strike.
Ooh!
Exactly. So it's kind of a nicer, softer option.
That is very polite.
Exactly.
I like that.
Yeah, after those 7 days pass, if they haven't taken any action, then we'll go ahead and remove that video for them, and they may receive that copyright strike.
Okay. So it's a 7-day schedule.
We give them a week to do the right thing.
To check their email and do the right thing.
Yes.
Yeah. Taking a look back at the tool, turns out we have a handful of videos that we have matches for in here. Do I have a way to bulk process these videos?
Yes, so glad you asked. One of the coolest features about this tool actually is the ability to do, or to take action on multiple videos at once, up to 50 actually.
Okay.
But it was one of the biggest pieces of feedback that we got during the early stages of the rollout. So creators had no idea that they could do this.
Okay.
It's one of the coolest parts, and they had no idea that they could do it. So we're working on an update right now to hopefully make this functionality a little bit more obvious
Okay. And
make sure our users can utilize this tool more efficiently.
Okay. But you did, so I asked that question on purpose. He did just show me how to use it, so I'll just talk through it in case you need to do this. So you go into your, what do we call it, the match tool?
Yeah, the copyright match tool.
Copyright match tool. And click on, pick one of the videos and click on request video removal. And then you can keep clicking that button all the way down on other videos, and then it'll bulk them up. And you can request video removal for all of those ones.
I should mention that this bulk action option is available for the other options too. So if you want to bulk archive, you could go ahead and do that just as well.
That's it from us. If you guys have more questions about the copyright match tool, there will be a link to the Help Center article about this in the description down below.
Thanks for watching. If you liked it, make sure you hit that like button down below. Feel free to leave any questions or comments down there too while you're at it. I'll be reading through those. Barbara will be reading through those.
Yeah.
They're really helpful, so keep that feedback coming.
And keep in mind, we are Creator Insider. We are your informal source for behind the scenes information from the tech teams. Please do hit that subscribe button and tick the bell to get notifications. We will see you in the next video. Bye!